the mass murderer, right? Payton, who decided he wanted to kill black people because of his racial hatred and indoctrination. One of the stories that has come out of that evil drama is an 8-year-old child who had to hide in a cooler to avoid being murdered. Let's put up her picture and the picture of her parents. The 8-year-old child, her name is Londin Thomas. Her parents are Julie and Lamont. This 8-year-old is now home with her family. Happy to be all together. She was with her parents when the shooter opened fire in a Buffalo, New York grocery store, killing 10 people. She could have been number 11. Londin Thomas, 8 years of age, her mom and her dad went to Tops Friendly Market to gather supplies for a cookout and a birthday surprise Saturday. When we went to Tops, we were buying some cake mix for my mama. She did not know. She was at the meat section so we could grill, Londin said. And then as the family was separated, shots rang out. Once they never stopped, you just gotta think, I know I'm not in this situation that I thought I'd ever be in, said Londin's dad, Lamont Thomas. The 8-year-old and her dad rushed to the back of the store, hiding in a cooler with the father's hand over his little girl's mouth. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine a mass murderer in a grocery store? You're there with your child to buy ingredients for a surprise party. And you have to hide your child in the cooler and put your hands over her mouth so the killer will not come and gun her down. We went to the back of the store where the milk is. The door was locked and we could not get out until the manager opened the door. Then we had to go out the back door. The cops let us out, the 8-year-old said. At that same moment, London's mom, Julie Hartwell, was at the front of the store trying to stay down. Gallons of milk were exploding around her as bullets flew. She says she could hear the suspect's footsteps getting louder. The 8-year-old said, and I quote, I was scared for my mom. I did not know what happened to her because she was at the front and I was at the back. I did not know where she was. I thought she was gone. You have to imagine an 8-year-old wrapping their minds around the severity of such carnage and evil in a split second, in a moment in life. She has to conceptualize what's happening. Once safely outside, the 8-year-old and her dad ended up on one side of the building, whereas her mom ended up on the other. Hartwell says those 20 minutes where she was separated were some of the longest moments in her life. 20 minutes later, they gave me my daughter. That was the most longest wait I've ever had in my life, she said. Throughout all of the chaos, the 8-year-old says she never felt scared because her dad was there. She said, and I quote, people say I'm a really brave girl. Let's put her picture up again. Let me say this, London, you're more than a brave girl. You are an amazing soul. And you are a brave girl because your mother and father are brave people. But beyond being brave, you are good. You are good. Goodness is inside of you. And I know you're good because when your life was in danger, all you could think about was the safety of somebody else. A.B., what are your thoughts?
I was gonna say the same thing, right? First and foremost, like, this is tragic, but I ask that we speak life into baby Londin. And I ask that this situation, as probably hard as it's gonna be on her, I ask that it gives her fuel and it motivates her in her future. It's a scary time right now, right? When white thugs, right? Predators, terrorists come into our neighborhoods bothering us. We not even bothering y'all, y'all bothering us for something that you've made up in your mind about what's going on in your own community and put us in these type of situations. As a mother, I can only imagine the fear of being a mother and being separated from my child at a time where I don't even know if I'm safe. I don't know what's going on. I don't even know why I'm being targeted at this point. We are in a dangerous state, and it's unfortunate that our black children have to go through this much trauma in 2022.
Yeah, and this is why we fight so hard against racism. This is why we fight hard against those that are apologists for racist ideology in this country, because literally they are creating atmospheres that lead to the death of good, decent, honorable men, women, and children.